Hello YouTube, this is Darkon633, and today we're taking a look at another Star Wars The Force Awakens Bladebuilders lightsaber review. This time we're going to take a look at Obi-Wan Kenobi's lightsaber based on his lightsaber featured in Star Wars Episode 3. Now, it could technically slightly pass as a New Hope lightsaber, but there are a few differences with the lightsaber sculpt that kind of doesn't help match it, even though technically, once again, just like with Luke's lightsaber, it's still taking the same lightsaber in terms of continuity-wise. Maybe not so much prop-wise, once again. Anyways, we're going to take a look at the box. It's in this typical Force Awakens Bladebuilders box. As you can see, it shows a picture of Ian McGregor as Obi-Wan Kenobi here. It shows Bladebuilders. And on the side, it even shows Sir Alec Guinness, actually, on the side here, since it is technically supposed to be the same lightsaber as mentioned earlier. Just the normal on the side of the box is normal, and it actually does say Revenge of the Sith as well. So now that's pretty much it that covers up the box. We're just going to put this up to the side here. Now we're going to take a look at the lightsaber itself. Now the lightsaber is, once again, just the typical standard type of lightsaber you've seen in the electronic Bladebuilders line. It does light up by pressing the button here. That's a really nice sound. I heard that some people's actually had a problem where it's a little bit... has a little bit of a malfunction due to the fact that the metal pin inside the actual screw hole there are missing in a few others, or the fact that the screw actually has accidentally went inside the lightsaber hilt itself. Mine, at least, turned out pretty decent, and I don't really have any problems with it, which is good. The only thing is that this probably is just the way that the lightsaber was designed in general, but the actual hilt isn't one of the most comfortable due to the fact that the rigids on the design of the lightsaber is a bit rough, and it's a bit bumpy that it is a bit uncomfortable sometimes to play around with, but it's not the worst I've seen. Anyways, here's how the lightsaber looks fully extended. So that's really nice. And we're going to take a look at it with the lights off. So we're just going to turn the lights off now. And here is how the lightsaber looks like with the lights off. And it's pretty nice, and it's got a really nice blue shine to it. Similar to the other lightsaber, it does have the normal accelerometer, or might have messed up the word, but and it's also got the heat detection as normal. Well, this isn't as clean as the Rey lightsaber that I have. It works okay. It's not the worst that I've seen. Anyways, we're going to take a look at the old lightsabers next to this one so we can have a full comparison. And here's how the three lightsabers that I currently own in the electronic Bladebuilders line put together. Now, I actually have not put the Kylo Ren lightsaber this time for two reasons. One, the fact that it is obviously the villain lightsaber, so I don't really count it in this picture right here. And at the same time, I kind of didn't have any more space to put any more lightsabers on there. So this is pretty much just how the standard, regular three electronic lightsabers look like in the Bladebuilders line. The only one I do not have is the Darth Vader one, and I most likely will still not get it, just the fact that I do have quite a lot of Darth Vader lightsabers already, so I really don't need another one, especially since they still have the regular standard hilt from the basic Bladebuilders line. Anyways, these still look really nice and helps captivate the three versions of lightsabers that are pretty much featured within the original trilogy in general, so we did at least get a pretty good representation for that. They have the same size hilts, roughly. Anakin's is a little different due to the fact that it does have the extra piece here, and obviously this is also featured on Rey's lightsaber, Luke's lightsaber, since it is still the same prop, but it's about the same otherwise, especially when you look at the two hilts. A lot of fans already kind of show a lot of similarities between the two hilts in general, so it's understandable why they look very similar, and it's really cool, actually, to have all three lightsabers together. Anyways, we're going to take a look at the lightsabers when the lights are off, though, so we can see how they fully look like lit. So there we go. Now, these two lightsabers, both Rey's and Obi-Wan's, have a very similar blue color, but I think one might be just a tad bit brighter, and I think that's actually Rey's, actually, since it's hard to see on camera, but this one has a slightly darker hue compared to this one, but it's just about the same color otherwise. You can see it does still have the hit detection, so that works really nicely. And I think the lightsabers work really nicely together. Now, just like the other lightsabers, This lightsaber also includes an adapter, since all the electronic lightsabers have this adapter in the various colors depending on what lightsaber it is. So, just like the Rey one, it's blue, and I don't remember where the other adapter went, but I think it's just about the same color as the one that came with Rey's. But, since it is still part of the Bladebuilders line, we can attach it if we wanted to. So, all you do is, once again, just slide it in and it snaps in. Like that. And we're just going to quickly attach to the Rey one, since it's both blue. So, let's turn the sabers off for a second. And here's how the sabers look like together. Fortunately, in this setup, I still can't really get it in a good way to show it, but I guess we can quickly try to turn up the lights and look at the lightsabers together. So, one moment. Let's see. So now we're going to take a look at how they look like fully extended and lit. So, once again, here you go. So, I really like how the system works, but obviously this is something that's mainly made for a toy aspect of the lightsaber rather than a prop aspect, obviously. But it does have a lot of cool ideas, I think, built into it, even if it still features the really annoying hole at the end, just for the adapter piece. But it's still really nice to see a Obi-Wan lightsaber even in the line, especially since we do not actually have a basic lightsaber this time around. So, it would be nice maybe in another wave if they could, maybe like a wave or two. We can see more lightsabers, and hopefully, if they do, we'll see an actual standard hilt for Obi-Wan's. Now, I know there was one released in the Rebels line, but I actually did not get that one. So, I would like to actually see just a standard Bladebuilders style hilt, fully collapsed. Especially since these have a lot better in terms of size of the hilt itself. Works really nicely, and I can't wait to see what other lightsabers we'll see maybe in the future. Anyways, I got this lightsaber from Hasbrotoyshop's eBay page, since I actually have been finding it in the stores a couple times, but every time I decided to pick it up, it kind of sold out and I never saw it again until the next time where the same pattern happened. So, I was finally able to get this thanks to Hasbrotoyshop and eBay, and they sent out really fast, and I really enjoy Hasbrotoyshop's service, so if you want to get a hold of this lightsaber, I'm pretty sure even as of this recording, they still have more lightsabers in stock on Hasbrotoyshop's eBay page. I'm not sure if it's actually available on their website as well, but I know for sure, at least from what I could tell, was also available on the eBay page. So, I highly recommend picking this up. Anyways, please comment, subscribe, and check out Hirotaku. Also, please check me on Twitter under Darkon633, and please check down the other channels down below. I'll be back for more Star Wars reviews, but for now, I'll be seeing you YouTube. Bye!